I'm terribly sorry. Could you tell them a story?
What did you mean? Stay with all of us.
Oh, he's someone about my friend Winnie the Pooh. He likes to hear about himself. He's that kind of bear.
I suppose he has a great adventure.
Yes, the only thing he likes more than adventure is eating honey.
Very well then, I will tell the story about the adventure and eating honey.
And the mood for food.
I'm stuck around and I have found
Coconut,
yum.
Yes, the gorse bush is very important in nature because it provides
provides shelter and food for animals.
Then Winnie the Pooh crawled out of the prickly forest bush and started to brush the prickles from his nose. He began to sing again.
I was listening. That's why I know where it is.
What is?
Honey. Honey.
I don't see honey.
There must be lots of honey.
Freshly made.
Papa Pooh, you're forgetting.
One delicious mouthful after another.
Papa Pooh, your diet.
My what?
I thought you were going on a diet.
I am going on a diet.
But not now.
Why not?
Because now I'm hungry.
That's not a good time to go on a diet.
Oh, I suppose tomorrow after you're done that dress.
And a good breakfast.
Yes, so how are you going to get there?
If I could just reach one of those branches.
One of those branches?
You don't happen to have a ladder, Mr. Piglet. Of course you don't.
Maybe I can give you a boost. If you sit on my shoulders.
Thank you for offering, Piglet. You're a true friend.
As Pooh and Piglet brushed each other off, Rabbit approached in a frenzy.
What's a frenzy? A type of vehicle?
No, a frenzy is a very exciting behavior.
Exactly. So Rabbit was quite excited as he approached Pooh and Piglet.
I don't like it. I don't like the sound of it. Pooh, Piglet.
Hello, Rabbit.
I suppose you've heard.
I'm not sure.
A strange animal is coming into the forest.
I heard.
Oh.
That's what I've been trying to tell from Pip, a strange animal. Her name is Tega. She's one of the fierce animals.
Very tall.
Enormous.
Any family? I believe she has one offspring.
Its name is Roo.
Tega is coming to live in the forest.
Yes.
Tega is coming, bringing an offspring named Roo. This is no time to be staring at the sky.
But Pip, for goodness sake.
I wasn't staring at the sky. What's all the excitement about?
Tega is coming, bringing Roo, but that's not all she's bringing.
What else?
Honey?
A bathtub.
A bathtub? What for?
Oh, surely you know what a bathtub is for. You fill it with water, you get in.
I do not. You wouldn't let that happen to me, would you?
You can count on me. Now you can see what all the excitement is about. We've seen a necessity for taking action.
When is Tega supposed to arrive?
Presently.
Does that mean she isn't here yet?
Yes.
What a relief. Because there's another matter I was.
Help!
Utterly miserable.
Good morning, Eeyore.
Good morning, Pooh Bear. It is a good morning, which I can tell.
Oh, surely it isn't that bad.
Perhaps not now, but it will be when she...
He means Tega.
Ah, you've heard.
About Tega?
Yes.
And baby Roo?
And the bathtub. And
the soap? Found out by chance.
Soap?
You didn't know about it?
What soap?
You didn't know? She carries a cake of the stuff in her pocket.
Soap?
Well, none of us know anything.
I believe the time has come. Yes, the time has come.
What time has come? For honey, I hope.
No. The time has come for answers.
And honey?
Maybe Christopher Robin knows something.
Maybe Christopher Robin has some honey. He always has a snack or two for Pooh.
Oh, Christopher Robin!
Now Christopher Robin lives in another part of the forest.
But just as Rabbit set off to find Christopher Robin,
crash!
Aren't you coming, Piglet?
I can't move.
Then all of a sudden, crash!
Pooh, look what you've done!
Oh, bother.
Pooh, is that you?
At least most of me seems to be here.
What happened?
A slight accident.
Slight? Didn't you notice that small tree over there?
The one growing very close to me.
The one with the honey at the top.
I don't see a small tree.
Just let me fly around.
It fell over just now.
I was in the small tree.
You mean that dreadful noise of the small tree falling?
And Pooh!
know.
What about going to see Christopher Robin?
So, once again, Pooh and his friends set off to find Christopher Robin. Christopher Robin would like to be near his friends so he could help them with their problems.
Of course, Pooh and his friends did see Kanga. They just never seemed to notice.
Black all over.
See, that was a clever disguise.
Where are you supposed to be?
I'm a little black drake cloud, of course.
Silly old bear.
Now, will you wait me at the beach, please?
Here, Pooh, hold on tight.
Yes.
Four.
Yes.
Three.
Yes.
Two.
Yes.
One.
Honey, 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 honey. There's just a robin. I think it means S-U-S-P-E-T-T something.
Perhaps you think you're after their honey.
Why, maybe that. You can never tell with bees. Christopher Robin, I've come into a very important decision. These are the wrong sorts of bees.
What does he mean, wrong sorts of bees?
Honey bees make honey, but there are numerous types of bees in nature, whether it's a bumblebee, carpenter bee, mason bee, but this bee was the honey bee. He's quite sassy as well.
Christopher Robin, hurry, the queen bee! You can never tell if bees!
Get her, your queen commands it!
Eight and eight and eight and eight and eight.
Hey, it's not a last visit, Rabbit, and rather sticky boy.
I must be going now. Thank you, Rabbit.
Well, goodbye. If you're sure you won't have any more.
Is there any more?
No, there isn't.
I didn't think so. Ooh, help it bother stop!
Oh dear. Well, it all comes from eating too much.
It all comes from not having front doors big enough.
Oh dear. There's no use. There's only one thing to do. Oh, the Christmas Robin. Oh my. Heavens to Betsy. I'm not in the book.
Yeah!
Dig that out of it!
never be able to use this front door again. It happened.
For proving, but the diet did for Pooh. And since we pledged to be unpledged, what we're going to do? He'll be cold and he'll be tucked, and eventually unplugged. We'll have a tug of war to open Rabbit's door. Being heathish, being coldish, and how the Pooh will go-ish. For mind over matter has made Pooh unfattered.
Hang on! bigger than a deer.
Happy Wednesday, Eeyore.
Thanks for noticing.
What a refreshing day for harvesting.
Happy Wednesday, Robin.
Who is it?
It's me. Please, Meg, Meg.
Oh, well, I say no. Someone is tasting piglets on my windowsill. Oh, look in, Pooh, too. What a surprise. Do come in and make yourselves comfortable. I'm practicing assuming it's a rather blustery day outside.
Yes, sir, Al. It's a very big blustery day outside.
Say, Al, is there any honey in that pot?
Oh, yes, help yourself. Now, I wouldn't go so far as to just call it a blustery day. Maybe a gentle spring zap. This is nothing compared to the big wind of 67. What's the last 76? Oh well, I remember the big blow well.
I remember this one too.
It was the year my Aunt Clara went to go visit her aunt. Now her aunt was not only gifted on the glockenspiel, but she, being a screech owl, also sang soprano in the London Opera. Her constant practicing so unnerved my other aunt that she laid down a C note by mistake.
Then all of a sudden, Al Street crashed to the ground.
That
was from page 41 all the way to page 62. Now the blustery day turned into a blustery night, and through the blustery night, a night filled with anxious sorts of noises. And anxious hat and who was very anxious. One of the sounds that he heard had never been heard before.
Since Tigger has caused so much trouble, Tigger
Do I say yes? Chickens don't like honey. That sticky stuff is only for hubbles and woozles. That's what I said. Hubbles and woozles.
What are they? I have a very puzzle.
Well, I do like puzzles. I find that I'm very good at them. That's what we thought!
Say, Owl. Penguin and I were wondering if you had any puzzles.
The faithful friends that Christopher Robin bought your part. The bag.
stay here. You'll search my son and my other moon. Hey, Bob, you'll be back soon. Back soon. Back soon. That sounds like back soon. Back soon.
The animals realized that they needed a plan to save Christopher Robin, so they turned to Al.
Al?
The greatest thinker of them all.
Yes, a plan. I have a plan. But let me think it over. Let me retire to my library and research the topic.
Oh, dear. I'm going to go hide.
Oh, dear.
Where are you going to hide, Rabbit?
Now, if I told you to, it wouldn't be hiding. Now, would it?
So, all the animals went and hid, except for...
Who?
Who came up with the plan of his own?
You did?
I did? Yes, you did,
Pooh.
Is it a clever plan?
The cleverest plan you've ever had.
Good.
So, who went and explained his clever plan to Piglet?
We are going to chop the backs.
That's a very clever plan to prevent
Pooh. We must dig a hole and make him and disguise it as something.
What are we going to disguise it as, Pooh?
Honey pot.
I'm not sure Bax like honey.
Why?
I don't know. We don't know that.
Then what should we disguise it as?
A picnic. Everybody likes picnics.
Clever idea, Piglet.
We'll go dig a hole.
So, Pooh and Piglet dug a hole in the ground. Both the bathrooms. As Pooh dug a hole, Piglet looked for a cloth to make it look like a picnic. They placed it over their hole. And scurried to get food for their baked cookie.
What does BYOH mean?
Bring your own honey.
Just so you know, you're welcome to.
Who Piglet went and hid so the Baxton wouldn't know that they set a trap?
In the meantime...
Must hide. Who? Well, I should perhaps take some provisions. Who knows how long I'll have to hide. Hufflepuff, the Baxton's caught me!
Well, what are you doing down there?
Help me, the Baxton's caught me. If I don't get out of this trap, he'll come take me away, just like he did Christopher Robin.
Well, grab my tail. I'll pull you out.
Thank you, Eeyore.
Now, what did you do that for?
Didn't mean to, it just came off in my hand.
Now I have to get another one. Probably won't be as good as the last one, because they never are.
Wait, Eeyore, don't leave!
I'll be back,
eventually.
Yes, hang on, we're trapped in a Baxton trap. Can you help?
Oh dear, why didn't you say that before? Tigger, if you could bounce her up to me, maybe I could reach down and help the rest of you out.
Oh! Baxton's bound to catch us now.
Suffering sassafras! What are you all doing down here?
The Baxton's captured us!
How to capture a Baxton by owl. All rights reserved. Now, the art of capturing a Baxton is extremely complicated, but I believe I am.
Owl, surely you can help us out of this trap?
Yes, I can, but it will require a lot of serious thinking.
Owl was seriously thinking. Lots of animals fell into a trap, like squirrels, rabbits. Skunks, frogs, and beetles.
It sounds like you captured a whole family of Baxtons.
Yes, yes. probably should hide, take a step back. They don't sound too happy.
Good idea, Piglet.
Well, we have to put this in the Robin. Maybe the bouncer can lead us to him.
Yeah.
Baxton, we surrender.
Who's Baxton? They're surrendering.
The Baxton's coming off for like an hour.
Let us out so we can discuss our terms of surrender.
We should probably help them out. They can lead us to this Robin. Because it was a really cool picnic.
It was even better than one I had for my birthday.
Everyone brought something.
Including carrots, lemonade, cookies, raspberry tarts, popcorn, peppers, all good stuff.
Think.